أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أنجبه لولايته واختصه برسالته وأكرمه بالنبوة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, it's been a very long time. I have been getting many messages from brothers and sisters asking where I have been, what I've been doing, if I'm even Shia. Of course, I've been getting a lot of brothers and sisters asking me because of an accusation that I have left Shi'ism. And of course, many brothers and sisters are asking, why did I leave for such a long time and so forth. So inshallah, we will address these points and get into it inshallah, bi-idhnillah. So of course, as for the accusation, if I have left Shi'ism and if this is true, this is not true. I am still upon the wilayah of Ahlul Bayt alayhum as-salam. I'm still upon the wilayah of the 12 Imams alayhim as-salam. Now of course my opinions have changed. This is very normal, this is very natural to happen. For anyone that researches and wants to further their studies in the uloom, the different Islamic sciences, their opinions will constantly change. So yes, of course, my opinions have changed in many areas. My methodology has changed. But inshallah, it's the methodology that reflects the Quran and the Sunnah, inshallah. So now, alhamdulillah, I am still upon tashayyu', still upon the wilaya of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad alayhum as-salam. But it is also important for us to understand that even if I have left tashayyu' will always stand. Hassan Al-Qadri is there or not, if someone else is there or not, if they are a famous figure, popular figure, a scholar, a student of knowledge, it doesn't matter. The Shayu' has survived throughout the harshest of generations and throughout the harshest of times, yet it still survived. So it will survive no matter what. It reminds me of the hadith attributed to Amir al-Mu'mineen, where he says, truth is not known by men. Know the truth first and then you know who abides by it. And that is a crucial principle for us to abide by. It doesn't matter if Tom, Dick or Harry left the Shia. It doesn't matter if Tom, Dick or Harry became Shia. What matters is the truth. And for us to be able to identify the truth and then know who abides by it, so that we know how to interact with them. If they are people of knowledge, do we follow them or not? These are all aspects that are very crucial when it comes to religion. And as the hadith says, that has been attributed to Imam Ja'far bin Muhammad al-Sadiq alayhi salam. And I say attributed because the hadith itself is mursal. It's found in the book of An-Nu'mani in his Al-Ghayba. وإمام الصادق says, من دخل في هذا الدين بالرجال أخرجه منه الرجال كما أدخلوه فيه كما أدخلوه فيه ومن دخل فيه بالكتاب والسنة زالت الجبال قبل أن يزول. The Imam is saying this hadith attributed to the Imam. It says, whoever entered this religion because of men will leave this religion because of men. Or as they entered this religion because of men, they will leave this religion because of men. And whoever entered this religion by the book and the sunnah, the mountains will be destroyed, or the mountains will move before he does. What is important is the Quran and sunnah, the kitab and the sunnah, that we abide by the Quran and sunnah, that we follow the Quran and sunnah, hold on to, steadfast upon the Quran and sunnah. So this is what is crucial, is that we hold on to the Quran and the Sunnah. Now, of course, the Sunnah that has been passed down to us by Muhammad and Ali Muhammad alayhi wasalam. So no matter what, Hassan al-Qadri or not, the Shay'a will live. The Shay'a will move forward. So inshallah, that clears up that point. As for where I've been, what I've been doing, why did I go missing? If I'm honest, I got very busy with different projects and it got too much. You know, every day I'm getting hundreds of messages. I can't keep up with everything. And I needed to focus on projects that I will be launching, inshallah, soon. And the brothers and sisters will, inshallah, be happy with the project, inshallah, bi-idhnillah. So I've been working on them, I've been studying, I've been researching, going back to things that I thought would be, you know, something of certainty, but I had to look back and maybe change my opinions on certain things. And just been focusing on myself. We live in an era of social media. Social media is a very dangerous place. You see, the qa'ada given to us by the Prophet and the al-Bayt السلام, is that actions are based upon intentions. So if you go to do salah and you're doing salah to show that you are someone that is pious and you pray, you will not get the rewards of salah. If you go and give charity and it's for intentions that are not pure for Allah, you will not get the rewards for it. In the sense that your intentions are everything. It's the baseline of everything. And I felt that I had to make sure that I go back to the reason why I actually started this whole thing, which is with pure intentions, inshallah, and for Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. For me to be able to propagate the religion of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad and help others and show them the light of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. So I had to take a step back because I feel like we have gone into that era of that generation where a lot of us are getting lost in that world, especially from the students of knowledge, the speakers and so on, and you can get really lost. And I thought to myself that, no, I don't want to get lost. I'm not here to get lost. I'm here to try to, inshallah, be guided and guide others as well, inshallah. And I had to purify my intentions. It was very important to me. It was scary as to the feelings I was getting and the different things I was doing that I felt was not necessarily haram, but not in line with, you know, the culture of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. So I felt that it's important that I go back and clear things in my head and make sure that I'm pushing myself towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that I'm bringing myself as near as I can towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, we are back. There will be many videos that I think will be important. We have been working hard behind the scenes, me and the brothers, that I feel they don't even get that much credit. A lot of people think it's just me doing everything. No, without my team, I'm nothing. this whole thing wouldn't be where it is. In this period, we have also started a Telegram channel for regular posts on different subjects and things like that. Alhamdulillah, those that have been or subscribed to the channel, their feedback has been positive, alhamdulillah. So inshallah, I will leave a link in the bio for anyone that wants to subscribe to that, inshallah. But let us put our heads together. Let us move forward. Let us give the world some of that light of Ali Muhammad alayhim assalam. Let us work and push forward, strive, struggle in the way of Allah, so that inshallah we can please Allah, His Messenger, and the Imams alayhim assalam. Alhamdulillah that we are upon the wilaya of the Imams of Ahlul Bayt. Alhamdulillah, we are upon the Salaf, the righteous predecessors of this Ummah, the Ummah of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad alayhim assalam. Hada wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa Ahli Baytihi al-Tayyibin al-Tahirin.